And today is Monday, April 20th, and we are sitting next to Enrique, engineer, Rafael, the video engineer, and Kristen, and Matt, also known as K10. What's going on, K10? Talk to me.
Not much, just chilling. Really excited about this. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So tell us a little bit about yourself. What's going on here? What kind of music are you playing today?
Well, today I'm just going to play a few acoustic originals that I wrote myself. Okay. One of which I wrote yesterday.
Sweet.
And then I'm going to play one cover. And yeah, right, pretty much. I have Matt here playing guitar for me. Shout out.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you, man.
Cool.
Talking to your guitar mic.
Oh, yeah.
So, care to tell us a little about your influences? You know, what kind of influenced you to write those five songs? Obviously, when it comes to music and obviously, you know, what's going on in your life?
Mm-hmm. Well, I started writing songs, I'd say, my freshman year of high school. And I basically get my drive to write a song from all the drama that's happening in my life. So I tend not to write as many songs when I have, like, when everything's going really well. It's kind of funny. But yeah, so I just write about, like, you know, relationships with people. Like, I've written songs about my mom, like, because I love her. And I've written songs about relationships I've had with boys, you know, stuff like that. So
okay, that's something that, you know, we can all relate to.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
All right, sweet. All right, guys. Well, first song by K10. Yeah, you ready to go?
Yeah. So the song is called Timing.
Timing. All right. Thank you guys for listening. Here we go.
Yep, you know it. Only a few people have heard these, so.
So who are the people that have listened to them?
Matt has obviously heard them.
I learned them all yesterday.
Honestly, we gotta clap it up for Matt being a musician to pick it up in one day, seriously. You know?
Not all of them, yeah. just a few yesterday.
I learned most of them yesterday.
Not true.
That's definitely really cool to hear. But yeah, so obviously Matt, you know, the guy in your company and whatnot. But mm-hmm. Have you collaborated with anybody in the past?
I have collaborated with people. I actually collaborate with a few rappers out of Chico. One named Yondi, and the other named Kalex, and the other named Briggs, and we're actually all part of this group called Underhouse. And basically what we're about is just like spreading the word about music and how it's great for the soul, basically. Yeah. So, yeah.
I'm obviously aware of Yondi and whatnot. He kind of talks about that too, definitely. Mm-hmm. Just, embracing the music, embracing the soul.
Yeah.
And that's really cool.
Spreading the love.
Spreading the love. I like
yeah.
That. All right, you ready for another one, or do you got a couple more things you want to say?
Yeah, no, I think I'm ready for the next one.
All right, for two.
All right, so this one is called High Off Lies. You keep me spinning round and around all the time. One day you up and put me down by saying you were fine without me. Now it's my turn. I was fine before you came into my life. In fact, I might have been better, except for when we're high. You don't care what they think, at least that's what you say, but I know that you do. Well, I am tired of all the bullshit now, and I am getting high off your lies. Except for when we're high. I was fine before you came into my life. In fact, I might have been better. Except for when we're now. That you know that you're a jerk. How do you? I wrote that one like 2 years ago.
Yeah,
it's one of my favorites though.
Okay, why is it one of your favorites?
It's catchy, I think. Kind of gets stuck in your head.
Yeah.
And it's fun to sing because I can get all aggressive about it.
Okay, yeah, you definitely get the sass in it.
Yeah, can put feelings into that.
Yeah, you're smiling, he's definitely hearing too.
Yep.
Well, I like that one because it's the fastest one.
Okay, yeah. But Matt, what are some of your influences? You know, I know you know Chris and whatnot, but you play all different types of music.
Yeah, I'm really influenced by stuff like Metallica and Nirvana and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I'm in a band in San Diego called Sacred Cow.
There you go.
This is just like my side gig, being a session guy.
Session guy and a good friend, I guess.
Definitely.
Well, actually, I didn't ask you earlier. So you said you wrote this 2 years ago. You know, have you like added to the lyrics, or have it always been the same lyrics since 2 years ago?
It's been the same since 2 years ago. Well, actually, with that song, I took an intro to music production class my senior year of high school, And I actually produced that song horribly, but I did. So I have had a lot of practice with it and just kind of have been able to like fine tune it a little bit more. Yeah. But yeah, so yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, kind of back to what you said earlier too, you know, uh-huh. The kind of music that you're writing and stuff, you know, it's relatable to people. You know, I was really listening to your lyrics and you can tell, like, yeah, you pulled stuff right, obviously, from your life. And
yeah.
It's definitely something I feel like a lot of people can relate to.
Yeah, I just kind of, like, a lot of people say that my lyrics are very straight up.
Yeah.
Like, there's a lot of people who write lyrics that are very, like, poetic and stuff, but I'd say that most of my lyrics are just very straight up and just get to the point. So.
A conversation. Yes, you are singing, but the, you know, the way it's coming out is like, oh, have a conversation.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. All right. Well, you ready?
Yeah. All right. So, fighter. Indecisive. I can't figure myself out. So undecided. Sometimes I wanna leave this town and never come back. Or maybe even just stay in bed forever. But I remember I'll never give up, no, never, never. Because I am a fighter, I'll run through the fire and never give up. When you see me, you'll be looking up. And when they tell me I can't, I wanna listen, cause they don't know where I've been. I am a fighter, I am a fighter. So depressed. Sometimes I feel like I can't go on. I'm fucking stressed and I feel so withdrawn. I wish that I could feel understood. But I remember I'll never give up, no, never, never. Because I am a fighter, I'll run through the fire and never burn up. When you see me, you'll be looking up. And when they tell me I can't, I wanna listen, cause they don't know where I've been. I am a fighter, I am a fighter. Burn up. When you see me, you'll be looking up. And when they tell me I can't, I wanna listen, cause they don't know where I've been. I am a fighter, I am a fighter. Yeah, really?
Yeah, I really, really like that. Well, mostly because, you know, I know you too, and you know how we always have these conversations about really trying to improve yourself and whatnot. Like,
yeah.
Definitely on a fighter, and it's like, that was cool. I like those lyrics a lot.
Yeah, and it's actually funny because I didn't write this song when I was in a good mood at all. I wrote this song when I was in a bad mood, and I was like, you know, when you're having hard days, you like, when you're growing up and maturing, you just have to learn how to pick yourself up. Like, no one can do it for you, you know? So that's why I wrote this. And like whenever I am down, I just kind of think about this and I'm like, no, you know what? I got this. So, you know, yeah.
You know, that's something you bring up that's really true for a lot of people. It's like, you got to be your own hype man. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, who's got your back? You can be yourself, you know what I mean?
Definitely.
And, that's cool. That's cool. You're thinking about that and whatnot. I just want to make a shout out to everyone. You can actually call us and you can ask Kristen a couple questions or just, you know, talk about how awesome your music is so far at 530-898-6228. Yeah, feel free to give us a phone call and, you know, maybe say hi to Kristen real quick and just take her break for a bit. Yeah, okay, so also got to let you guys know that we're broadcasting live since 1951. You listen to KCSCRadio.com. KCSC is a program of associate students at Chico State in Chico, California. KCSCRadio.com. I'm Aldire with K10. And so, yeah, do you got...
I also did want to say one thing. So this next Wednesday, April 29th, Underhouse is having a show on the lawn across from the BMU. I'm pretty sure that's called Trinity Grounds or something.
Yeah,
it's at noon. Yeah. So you guys should all come out and see what Underhouse is about. It's going to be awesome.
Next Wednesday.
Mm-hmm. April 29th, correct.
Oh, sweet. All right, yeah. yeah, okay. You almost don't eat
any. It helps my voice.
Don't you guys have an EP coming out, too?
We do have an EP coming out as well. And that's coming out in late September, Under House Music.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. It's called This Is It.
Oh, This Is It?
This Is It. Yep. Hardcore. We're about to run shit.
So that's also definitely a helpful thing. It's just like, there was like, that one song, we had one cuss word, it was fucking, right? And it's like, mm-hmm. We're on a station that's allowed to cuss, you know?
It's awesome. I like cussing.
Obviously, you can't just be belting out the F-bomb every now and then, but, you know, yeah, it's kind of
cool. I like to throw a cuss word in my songs every year and every now and then.
Oh, it's just a little sassy.
Yep. It's definitely like, me.
Sometimes I think that's like what you need. Like, if you use something else, it just wouldn't give you the point, you know?
Yeah.
Definitely.
There's a big flashing light and stuff. Whenever that happens.
Hello? Yeah, you can talk to Kristen.
Hello? Who is this? Hi, guys. Hi, love you. Thanks. All right, see ya. Those are the girls from my floor. Shout out second floor, Whitney.
Yeah, freshman.
Yep.
All right, well, that's all you, Kristen. Go for it.
All right, so now we're going to sing a cover. This is one of my favorite songs to sing. And it also is kind of a thing in my life right now, so that's why I'm excited to sing it. This is When I Was Your Man by Bruno Mars. Same bed, but it feels just a little bit big now. Gave you all my hours when I had the selfish ways. It costs a good strong woman like you to walk out my life. Now or never, now I get to clean up the mess I made. Oh, and it haunts me every time I close my eyes. It all just sounds like ooh. You flowers and held your hand. I should've gave you all my hours when I had the chance. Take you to every party, cause all you wanted to do was dance. Now my baby's dancing, but she's dancing with another man. Although it hurts, I'll be the mistakes. I just want you to know. I hope he buys you flowers. I hope he holds your hand. Give you all his hours when he has the chance. Take you to every party, cause I remember how much you love to dance. Do all the things I should've done. When I was a man. Yeah, I love singing that song. It's a very sad song. It's a good one, though.
Wrapping it up, you know, that's your last song, right?
Or... I have one more song.
Oh, yeah, one more song.
Yeah, or no, I have two more songs.
Oh, I apologize. I think that was because I completely covered in
mine. Yeah. I still have two more. Can't get rid of me yet. No, it's all good. It's all good. Yeah, I got two. So, all right, I guess I'll just jump right into it. This song is called Didn't Ask.
Kind of forget how this one goes. So tell me if I'm going, like, just okay. Tell me if I need to speed up or something.
All right, will do. But I got it, yeah, I got it, I got it. I didn't ask for you, but I got you, yeah, I got you, I got you. I wasn't ready for this, I wasn't ready for you, for you. Be cause you still got mad at me. What more do I have to do to make you happy? I told you I'd come in peace, you still got mad at me. Yeah, you still got mad at me. I hope you know that I care, even though you broke all your promises. I hope you know that it hurts, cause after what you did, all I can say is how was loyal even when I didn't have to be, and you still got mad at me. I guess I should have known how this was gonna be. Got mad at me. What more do I have to do to make you happy? I told you I'd come in peace, you still got mad at me. Yeah, you still got mad at me. I didn't think that this would happen. Hey, shout out to allergy season.
I'll suffer today.
Yep.
Shout out to this cough.
Yeah, same.
That wasn't planned. I actually had to call.
Walk us through that song a little bit. Like, first, I actually haven't really asked you. Like, who helps you write, like, the changes on guitar and whatnot, and all the.
I'm sorry. One more time.
Who helps you, or who, do you write the changes on guitar, or all the different?
Well, like, okay, so I write all my songs on the piano, so I'll come up with, like, a chord progression, and then I kind of just, like, melodies pop into my head. But Matt kind of, like, puts his own spin on things sometimes, so, like, that end part he came up with.
That was
yeah, but it actually kind of happened by accident, like, we were playing
yeah,
that last part.
Yeah, I just
part,
screwed up.
And then I was like, wait, hey, that sounds really good, cool. Yeah. So, yeah, that's the end part, but anyway, so, I come up with the chord progressions, though,
yeah.
For the most part, yeah.
That's really impressive, Kristen.
Thanks.
Really.
Thanks.
Yeah, for those who can't see, you know, Kristen in general is just a preppy person, but at the same time, you know, you gotta understand, those are some pretty, you know, deep lyrics. You gotta go to a certain place to be able to kind of really...
Got me feeling
that
some type of way.
Kind of
yeah.
Song, you know?
Yep.
Do you go to a certain place when you sing, or...
Yeah, like, when I'm writing, it's just, like, I'll start to feel really upset about something, and I just get, like, all tied up inside, you know, and I feel like I just need to get it out. And sometimes I'll just talk to a friend about it, and sometimes I just need to write a song, and so I write a song about it. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, it just all comes out, like, pretty fast, and it just kind of, like, happens.
That's pretty cool. Like, it's almost like, you know, imagine, like, a hot water, but I was hot water in your body. Like, I gotta get this out.
Yeah.
Of and so, you know, that's really cool. But,
yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting because, like, when you meet Kristen, she's, like, such a friendly person, but she's really been through some shit, dude. And you wouldn't
yeah.
expect it from how you carry yourself.
Thanks. All right. Yeah, so this is my last song. This is the one that I wrote yesterday. Yeah,
I thought
so.
That one was Fighter.
No, I wrote this last one yesterday on Sunday. Yeah, Matt is talented. Okay, so yeah, this song I wrote yesterday, so it's very new, but it is also my favorite song, probably because I'm still feeling those emotions pretty hard, but yeah, no, I really like this one a lot, and Matt really likes this one too, because it's a drop D, so yeah.
I just like the tune, dude, but it is fun to play.
This is called Second Chance.
Again, tell me if I need to speed up or slow down.
All right, will do. Sunday afternoons, not the same. And if I had the chance, I'd change everything. But I let you go. I was wrong and I don't don't know what to do to make it up to you. I miss when we used to go on starlight walks, and I hope you miss our long talks. But I let you go, and I was wrong, and I don't know what to do, because I need you. I really miss the way you used to smile at me. You'd tell me I was cute, and then you'd tickle me, and I hope you give me a second chance, 'cause I just want to hold your hand. I never should have said goodbye. I can never do what's right, 'cause I let you go, and I was wrong. I guess making mistakes is a part of life. I really miss the way you used to smile at me. You'd tell me I was cute, and then you'd tickle me, and I hope you give me a second chance, 'cause I just want to hold your I just want to say thank you for listening. If you tuned in, I hope you liked everything that I wrote. And yeah, I hope you liked it. And if you did, shout me out. Be like, hey, I listen to you on the radio. So yeah, thanks, Hobby, for having me.
Yeah, so Bomb Shelter Sessions, this is the kickoff tomorrow, same time, 5 to 6. Wednesday, 3 to 4. And Thursday, 8 to 10. And